In this video today, I will review the latest 2024 CarPlay Smart AI Box model from the Carbotix brand. This new car media adapter from Carbotix is called CarPlay 2 Droid 2024. This adapter runs on the latest Android 13 operating system with 4 gigs of RAM and 64 gigs of internal storage that can be expanded with a micro SD memory card. It also supports 4G SIM card connection to access internet, or you can connect this adapter with your mobile's hotspot. So what you get inside the box is the standard user manual, a cable to connect the adapter with your car's USB slot, and the Carbotix CarPlay 2 Droid Smart AI Box. Now let's connect it with the car, and then we start testing the different functions, features, and some frequently used apps on this new Carbotix Smart CarPlay adapter. So keep watching, guys. All right, friends, so I'm in my car. I've got the Carbotix CarPlay Smart Media Adapter with me here. Now I'll connect this with my car. But at the same time, I would like to see how long does this device take to start and get to the main homepage of the Android system. So I've got my stopwatch with me here as well. So now let me connect with this with my car through the USB cable. Let's start the timer. All right, so around 28, 29 seconds. All right, friends, so this is the main homepage or the landing page of the Android 13 operating system on this device. Looks quite nice. It's very decent in terms of the size and the different widgets. You've got the main navigation here. You've got the connections here. So you've got Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, and the 4G signal. You've got date and time. Then you've got the media playing. This box will show you some of the recently used applications. And right at the bottom, you have these 5 spots to add favorite applications. And then finally, you've got the settings here. These buttons will take you to the full app view. So if you click here, you get to see all the different applications that are pre-installed on this device. And I've in fact installed a few extra ones just for the test today, but most of these apps were pre-installed. And then, as I said earlier, we've got 5 spots here to add favorite applications. So we can go and, you know, add a few favorite ones that we will test later on in this video. But it's a very nice user-friendly kind of a user interface layout of the main page or the landing page. So what I'll do now is, in order to test the performance of this new Carbotix CarPlay 2 Droid Smart AI Box, I will start testing the different functions and the features and some of the frequently used applications as well. So the first thing that we need to do here is actually connect this adapter with internet. Now there are 2 ways to connect this with internet. One is you can insert a SIM card. This device supports 4G SIM card compatibility, so you can insert any SIM card or a data SIM card in this device, and then this device then always remains connected to internet. Or if you don't want to do that, you can connect it through your mobile's hotspot as well. And it's a very easy process. So you just simply go to the settings here, and you can actually go to the more settings option. This is where you actually get all the Android settings, like any Android device. You've got network, you've got devices, apps, preferences, storage, display. So you can set that up. What we need to do is go to the internet connectivity, click on internet. Then you get to see the different internet available or the Wi-Fi signals available. I've already connected with my mobile's hotspot, as you can see. So you simply select one, insert the password, and then it gets connected. So it's very quick to connect. And then it always remains connected. So as next time you come into your car, if your mobile has the mobile hotspot on, the device will automatically detect the connection and then connect to internet just the way we did it. So the signal is already on because my mobile was already switched on, and the device then connected to my mobile's hotspot. So these are 2 ways to connect the device with internet. All right, so the first app that I would like to test on this adapter is YouTube, which is the most frequently used application. So let's go to the YouTube app. It takes probably 1 second or 1.5 second for the app to load. And, you know, it looks quite nice. It's very quick to load the thumbnails. It doesn't take much time. So as you go up, you know, all the thumbnails are already loaded. So now let's play one of the videos. All right, so let's play one of my videos here. And two things I would like to test here is whether we can use mobile steering wheel for controlling the volume. Two, whether we can get 1080p resolution from YouTube application. And the third one is to see if there is any sort of sync issues. Now, some other devices I've tested, there was a bit of issue with the audio and the video not being in sync. So that's why let's test that. So let's blow this up and then increase the volume.
The famous corporate brand has launched their first ever portable car screen with the Android operating system.
All right, so the first good news is that we can use the steering wheel control to control the volume. And the other thing is that the audio and video is completely in sync.
It runs on the Android operating system with 2 gigs of RAM and 32 gigs of internal storage that can be expanded with a micro SD card or a USB flash drive.
So the audio and the video is completely in sync. Now, the other thing I wanted to test is whether we can get 1080p output quality resolution on the YouTube app. Let's go and see. So we can actually get maximum 1080p on this screen, though I don't actually recommend playing 1080p video on this because it's a small screen. 720p is more than enough. You should not overload the app or your internet connection. So this device can actually play up to 1080p on YouTube, which is a good news. So quite happy with the YouTube. And as you can see, the quality is quite nice. It's very smooth. It doesn't lag, buffer. It doesn't drop frames. And we can also use the steering wheel control. All right, so now let's test the all-important navigation app. So we've got option of using the Google Map, which is a pre-installed app, or you can install your own navigation app like Yango or Waze, depending on what you prefer. So we can use this Google Map here. It's a pre-installed in this window, but actually I like the Waze one. It's slightly better in looks and feel. So let's see if this is working. So very quick to load, and we can actually resume the last destination, again it's calculating the route and the time. So there you go. All right, so looks quite nice, and the screen is quite responsive as well, so that's nice. So the navigation is working fine. Now this device comes with built-in GPS system, so you don't have to actually connect any external GPS antenna. It already has that GPS antenna built into this adapter, and as you can see, the navigation is live. It looks quite nice. Now, the other nice thing in this adapter, just like some of the other adapters that I've tested, is something called the split screen function. Now, the split screen function allows you to have two applications running side by side at the same time. So what we need to do is go to this mini floating menu, click on the split screen, and then it will take the running app on the left side, Waze, and then we can select another app to run on the right side, like YouTube. So now you can see there are two windows, navigation on the left side and the YouTube app running on the right side. And both these are active. They're running, the video is playing here, and the navigation is also live. And again, this is one of my favorite feature in any of these CarPlay adapter, because this allows your friends and family traveling with you to also watch something on the right side while you focus on the navigation on the left side. All right, so the next thing I would like to test on this device is whether I can play high resolution video files through the micro SD card that I've already installed onto this adapter. So what we need to do is actually go to the full app view here, and then look for the file folder. And then what we need to do is go to my SD card, and I've got a few sample videos, and I've got 4K, but I don't want to test 4K because it doesn't make sense to have 4K playing on such a small screen. But we can go and play 4K 24 frames per second just to see if it works. Yeah, so 4K 24 frames per second videos are working. Let's go mad and see if we can get 4K at 30 frames per second. All right, so that's also working, but it's not working smooth. It's basically lagging and dropping a few frames. So again, if you want to play 4K videos on this, I would recommend you to stick to maximum 4K at 24 frames per second. But I would stick to having maximum of 1080p full HD, even at 60 frames per second, it shouldn't be a problem. There you go. So this is full HD video file at 60 frames per second. As you can see, it plays very nicely, absolutely smooth, no lagging, drop frames, no buffering at all. And the colors are very nice. And the clarity, again, it also depends on your screen in the car. If it's a very high resolution screen, then the output would also look quite good. All right, so these were all the frequently used applications. Now let's test the all-important wireless Apple CarPlay. So what we need to do is actually go to this icon here. This is the connections page, and this is where you can actually find instructions on how to connect this device to the Apple CarPlay or to the Android Auto system. So first let's try to connect this with the Apple CarPlay, and what we need to do is actually go to the iPhone and open the Bluetooth section and then look for a new device here, CarBotics. So we click on CarBotics, pair the device, allow it to sync contacts and favorites. And that's it. So very quick to connect, just a couple of messages. And then, the connection between the adapter and the mobile establishes, and then you get to the home page of Apple CarPlay. Again, it's a very quick connection and it's a one-time connection. You just need to create this connection between the adapter and the phone once. And then every time you switch on the car, as long as the Bluetooth on your iPhone is switched on, the adapter will detect the connection and take you to the home page of Apple CarPlay that looks like this. So this is the standard CarPlay main page. You've got navigation here, then you've got the media on the right side, you've got some shortcut icons, and you can also use the voice command through Siri or through your iPhone. So looks very nice, very quick to connect. If you want the full page navigation, you can click on this, you get the full page navigation, and the screen is also quite responsive. That's quite nice. You click here, you get to the split screen. Now I won't be explaining the different functions and features of Apple CarPlay in this video. If you want to know more about it, you can go and watch some of my other videos. All I wanted to see was whether we can connect wireless CarPlay through this adapter. So it looks quite nice. You can actually get all the different applications available on your phone and that are compatible with Apple CarPlay appearing here. So very quick to connect with Apple CarPlay, looks quite nice. Now let's go and check the wireless Android Auto system. So we exit this system. All right, so now let's connect to the wireless Android Auto system. So we click on this link adapter again. And then this is the main page of connection. So we need to follow the same kind of instructions as we did with the iPhone. So on the Android mobile, go to the Bluetooth section and look for a new device. It would be the CarBotics. There you go. So click on CarBotics, pair the device. So that's it. Just one message, and then you'll see the connection has started. And now in a few seconds, we should be able to see the homepage of the Android Auto system appearing on the car screen here. There you go. So just like the CarPlay system, the Android Auto is also quite quick to connect. Again, this is a one-time connection that you need to establish between the Android mobile and the adapter. And then, every time you switch on the car, you can directly go to the system as long as the Bluetooth on your Android mobile is switched on. So this is the main homepage or the landing page of the Android Auto system. Looks very similar to CarPlay. So you've got the navigation on the left side, and then you have the media running on the right side here. And then, you've got some of the shortcut here, and you can also use the mobile, or you can also use the voice command just like Apple CarPlay. So if you want the full navigation view, you can click here and you get the full navigation view. Now I don't have internet on my mobile, so I'm not getting the navigation here. That's why there is no map appearing. But if your mobile is connected, you'll see the navigation just like the Apple CarPlay. And then you click on this button here again, you get to see the full app view. These are all the apps that are available on Android Auto system that are installed on your phone. And then you've got the settings where you can change the look and feel and the wallpaper. But again, I won't be explaining the different functions and features of Apple Car or Android Auto in this video. If you want to know more about it, you can go and watch my videos. All I wanted to see whether the Android Auto is connecting, and it's connecting quite nicely, very quick to connect, and looks quite nice as well. So Apple CarPlay as well as Android Auto, both platforms are connecting, quick to connect, and looks quite nice on the screen. So now let's go out and back to the native Android 13 system. All right, friends, so this was a quick review of this new CarPlay to Droid Carbotics Smart AI Box. We've tested different functions and features. Everything worked amazingly well. All in all, it's a very nice CarPlay adapter with all the nice functions and features. So if you like it, if you want to buy this, simply go to the link in the description of the video. It will take you directly to the official store where you can buy this new Carbotics CarPlay to Droid Smart AI Box. That's it, friends. If you like my content, you can go and support this channel with the super thanks icon below. And if you are new to my channel, please do subscribe and click on that bell icon so you won't miss out on any of my upcoming videos. Thanks for watching, guys.